Hey guys, my name is Denver Riddle and I'm a colorist. I want to share with you how you can get that big budget look with my free cinematic LUTs that you can download in the description. Hey, my love, I think we said hello to a soul tonight. Yes, I'm right here. So if you're struggling with coming up with looks or getting that film look that sets you apart, then these are for you. Now, unlike a lot of the other LUTs that are out there that may leave much to be desired or are just simple color washes or color tints, these LUTs are actually based on Hollywood films. The LUTs that you're gonna be getting are based on such films as Drive, Mad Max Fury Road, and Moonrise Kingdom. Plus, you'll be getting other LUTs based on complex looks, a few film print emulations, and a collection of log to Rec 79 LUTs for converting your flat looking log footage from your camera into something more pleasing. All right, let's jump into this. So after downloading the zip, you'll want to double click on it to reveal the LUTs inside. You'll find that they're categorized into three folders for film looks emulating 35 millimeter film, log to Rec 79 LUTs for several different cameras, and look LUTs for applying creative and other distinct looks from popular films. Now I'm gonna show you how to get these into and start using them in Adobe Premiere, DaVinci Resolve, Final Cut Pro 10, and Cinema Grade on the Mac. You can skip directly to your application by clicking on the timestamp for your software in the description. Let's start with Premiere. Simply go to Library, Application Support, Adobe, then Common Folder. Here you should find a folder named LUTs. If it's not there, just create it and inside add two folders named Creative and Technical. Now you just want to copy and paste entire folders here. Now let's open Premiere. In the basic correction panel, you'll find the log to Rec 79 LUTs in the Input LUT drop-down menu. If you've recorded in log, just simply find the LUT for your camera and that'll give you a good starting point. Now, I want to emphasize something here. If you use LUTs to address log, I only suggest using them if you're in a hurry because color correcting the image manually and adding your own contrast is going to give you the best results, okay? Now, once you've gotten your footage to a good base starting point, you can then add a creative look. So if you go to the creative panel, you'll find a drop-down menu of the different LUTs. I'm going to apply the Drive LUT because I love its sweet awesomeness. Now here's the thing, if a LUT is too strong, that's actually not a bad thing because we can dial it back to taste with the intensity slider. What we're effectively doing here is changing the LUT's opacity. Now if you don't like choosing LUTs from a drop-down list or find the built-in preview limiting because it doesn't show changes we made in the base correction panel, with Cinema Grade for Premiere running on the Mac, you can actually organize and preview all your LUTs as thumbnails, so this makes finding the right look for your project faster and easier. Okay, now for DaVinci Resolve, open the Project Settings window and select Color Management. Here you'll find the Open LUTs folder button, so go ahead and click on it to take you to a folder where we'll find all of the DaVinci LUTs. Here we'll paste our three LUT folders. Back in DaVinci, we then just need to click Update Lists, and don't worry if this takes a while, it's just refreshing the LUT directories in DaVinci. Okay, so now in the 3D LUT section in the Nodes drop-down menu, we'll find the three folders. Again, if you've recorded in log, just simply find the LUT specific for your camera and that should give you a good starting point. If we need to make additional changes, we can do that with the color controls. I personally prefer to color correct log footage manually to give me the best results, but if you're in a time crunch, the log to Rec 79 LUTs can come in handy. Okay, so now that we've established a good base correction in the first node, let's add another node where we can begin working on a look. Now what's really cool about DaVinci is that we can preview LUTs as thumbnails so we can actually see what they do before applying them. To do that, we'll open the LUTs window and hover our cursor over the LUTs to see a preview. I'll choose the Mad Max LUT and double click to apply it. It's too strong here, so a clever trick is to go to the key panel and dial back the look to taste with the key output gain control. And that's it. We can refine the look further if we need to with the color tools. And finally, in Final Cut Pro 10, to import the LUTs so we can begin using them, we'll apply a custom LUT effect under Video Effects. In the Inspector, we'll open the LUT drop-down menu and click the Choose Custom LUT option. From here, we can either import a single LUT or a folders of LUTs. In this case, I'll import the log to Rec.709 folder and choose the LUT specific to my camera. There, that gives us a good starting point. From here, we can add the color wheels effect and position it above the custom LUT effect. We can now make additional exposure and color balance changes until we have a good base correction. Now we're to the exciting part of exploring different looks, so why not apply a Hollywood film look like Moonrise Kingdom? To do that, we need to add another custom LUT effect, and we'll leave it at the bottom of the stack. We'll then import the Looks folder and choose the Moonrise Kingdom LUT. Now, if it's too strong, that's perfectly okay. We'll just dial back the look to taste with the mix slider. And bon appetit! Now, if you don't like choosing LUTs from a list, which is kind of like banging your head against a desk, with Cinema Grade, you can get real-time previews of all your favorite LUTs, making it faster and easier to choose the right look for your project. Okay, so how this works is you go to the Cinema Grade menu, LUTs, then Reveal in Finder. Here we'll paste all of our look LUTs. Then back in Cinema Grade, in the Look Selection panel under LUTs, we'll find a preview of all of our LUTs. We'll choose the look that we want, then click Accept. And then just dial it back. And voila. With Cinema Grade, it's a fast and easy way to organize and preview LUTs. Plus, it has really cool on-screen grading controls. So you can get these LUTs, learn more about Cinema Grade, or sign up for our free online color grading workshop, then click the links below in the description. We want to help you make the look of your films stand out. So if you like this video, please consider giving it a like, hit that subscribe button, and if you want to be notified when our next color grading video comes out, then click the bell next to the subscribe button. All right, over and out. Enjoy the free LUTs. Hey, my love, I think we said hello to our soul.